Yes, guys. So let's start with consolidation with an associate and a joint venture. Associate is discussed as per AS 23. Joint venture discussed in AS 27. Associate, the method of consolidation is called as equity method. And for the joint venture, we call it as proportionate consolidation method. Yes guys, first let's understand this proportionate consolidation, because once you get AS 21, 27 is very similar on lines. Let's say I have a holding and a subsidiary having an equity share capital of 500. If my reserves and surplus is 850 and my other liabilities is 150, assets and investment in S, let us say investment in S is 275 and 1225. Subsidiaries equity share capital is 100. Reserve and surplus is 150. Other liability of 50. And I have assets of 300. Let's say holding holds in subsidiary, but 80%. And this was acquired exactly on the same day. Then how do we solve the problem? First we need to check for cost of control. How do we check for cost of control? Check the share in net assets. Net assets is assets minus outside liabilities, or equity share capital plus reserve. The share in net asset, the total net assets is 250. His share is 80% of it. That means 200. He is purchasing the investment for 275. So when I solve cost of control, we'll have to consider the cost of control, cost of investment 275, compare it with your share in net assets 80% of 100 plus 150. 100 plus 150 share of 80% is 200. Comparing these two, I'll get a goodwill of 75. What about minority interest? Minority interest is minority share in net assets. What is minority share in net assets? If 80% is held by holding, 20% is held by minority. Their share in net assets. Net assets is 100 plus 150 again. And this will become 50. Now if I have to present a consolidated balance sheet of H Limited, then we'll write like this. Equity share capital 500. There's no post-acquisition reserve because on the date of acquisition I'm giving it. So I'll write reserve and surplus of 850. Minority interest is 50. My other liabilities, full consolidation, 150 plus 50 is 200. On the asset side, I'll get assets 300 plus 1225, 1525, and also value of goodwill 75, total being 1600. Balance sheet will tell you. Now the similar thing, if instead of calling this as a subsidiary, if I'll start calling it as joint venture, what difference does it make? When I'll call it as a joint venture, I need to follow proportionate consolidation. Why do you get minority interest? Because we are doing full consolidation, we get minority interest, saying that I am adding the total net assets of 250 into your consolidated balance sheet. So out of this 250, 50 rupees belongs to minority interest. That's the reason why I'm writing minority interest. But when we are solving as per AS 27, first logic, there's no minority interest because I'm following proportionate consolidation. Now, how will my balance sheet look like now? Check. Equity share capital, 500. Reserves and surplus, same thing, 850. I don't have a minority interest to be written here. So what are my other liabilities now? Check. Other liabilities should be added like this. 150 already existing plus 80% of 50, 40, 190. Assets 1225 plus 80% of 300 is 240. 240 plus this one is 1465. And finally, I have a goodwill of 75. Again, at 1540, your balance sheet should tally. Now if you want to make it on the general lines, what do you do as far as your joint venture is concerned? I'll say I'll follow every step. I'll follow the same steps. One step I can exclude, that is regarding your minority interest. So there's no step 6 at all. The remaining step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5, step 7, again for the reserves for CBS, everything is same. Step 6 is cancelled. Step 8, when you follow the consolidated balance sheet, when you start preparing, we need to add only proportionate net assets. That's the only logic. So you can start writing the steps now. When you solve as per AS 27, date of acquisition as usual, step 2, shareholding pattern, we don't call it as holding interest, now we call it as venturer's interest. Only venturer's interest you calculate. I don't have to calculate minority interest at all. The other person is not called as a minority, he is also called as co-venturers. So you can't call him as a minority, there is no minority interest here. There's only venturer's interest in the joint venture. That's it. Analysis of reserves. Of the joint venture. With respect to date of acquisition. Step 4, distribution earlier in distribution of reserves we used to identify both the holding company share as well as minority interest share, but here when I calculate pre-acquisition and post-acquisition I'll only calculate venturer share. Only the venturer share. No minority interest share at all. Like I told you, he is not called as minority interest. He is called as co-venturer. His share is not necessary to be calculated. Step 5. Cost of control. Absolutely the same thing. Cost of investment minus pre-acquisition dividend. Compare it with share in net assets. Your net assets include both share capital as well as your pre-acquisition reserves. Same thing. This step 6 is cancelled now. There is no minority interest to be calculated. So now my step 6 will become directly your reserves for CBS. No change. Take holding company share plus share in post-acquisition reserves plus post-acquisition dividend. Pre-acquisition, I have taken it in cost of control. This one, I'll take it in reserves for CBS. This is step 5. And now this became step 6. Now when I prepare consolidated balance sheet, in the case of net assets, add holding company share plus proportionate joint venture share. Only the proportionate joint venture share. You hold 60% of the joint venture, add 60%. You hold only 40% of the joint venture, add only 40%. So whatever is your percentage in the joint venture, you add for the net assets. Yes guys, it is as simple as possible for the joint venture. Then let's think about associate now. This is comparatively easy when you talk about age 21 to 27 because I am eliminating one working note altogether. Age 23 becomes even more easy when you are talking about associate because there is no line by line addition of the net assets at all. You don't have this at all. What happens when you are solving as per AS 23 is consolidation with an associate. In the consolidated balance sheet of holding company, all the items remain the same except two figures. The first figure is your reserves. Obviously, when there's a change on the liability side, there should be a change on the asset side. And this change on the asset side is called as carrying cost of investment. When do you call it as an associate? When your shareholding is greater than or equal to 20%. And less than or equal to 50%. Even equal to 50% is an associate. Even equal to 50% is an associate. Equal to 20% is also an associate. These are the only two changes that we do. Normally, even when we are solving as per 21 or 27, if you observe, in the consolidated balance sheet, I never got investments. Because the investment in the subsidiary or the investment in the joint venture was cancelled and we identified something called as a goodwill which appeared in the balance sheet there. So I cancelled the investments altogether. But as far as this problem is concerned, when you are solving as per associate, I am still finding the investment. That means I do not cancel the investment against the share in the net assets at all. All we do is there is a share in the net, your reserves for CBS should be changed, your carrying cost of investment should be changed. What are the changes in these two? We'll understand. First, take down till here.
of
Yes guys, what we are discussing is equity method. Step 1, date of acquisition as usual. Shareholding pattern, we identify investing party interest. Guys, when we find out investing party interest, I don't have to calculate minority. Why? Because you yourself are minority. You hold 20 to 50%, you have no majority share in that. So what we calculate is only investing party interest, no minority interest below. Only the party's investing party interest, 20%, 25%, 30%, 35%, 40%, whatever it is, up to 50% we call it as investing party interest only. Then normal analysis. Analysis of reserves of the associate with respect to date of acquisition. What do we do in our analysis? The reserves will be identified as pre-acquisition and post-acquisition. Distribution of reserves, pre-acquisition and post-acquisition, we distribute it only for shareholding pattern. We have seen this word, only for investing party interest. A normal cost of control, like we always calculate, no change. But the only change is the goodwill or capital reserve that you get in cost of control. This will not appear in the consolidated balance sheet. Then why did you calculate? This should be the biggest question. When it is not appearing in the consolidated balance sheet, then why should I even calculate? I'll use this figure. I'll use this figure, but I will not post it into my consolidated balance sheet. It's not an item in the consolidated balance sheet. Like I told you, there's no goodwill or capital. I'm not cancelling the investment. I'm holding the investment just like that in the balance sheet. If I cancel, I get goodwill or capitalism. I'm not cancelling it there. I don't need minority interest. Not at all. Because there's no minority. No minority interest working note. So I'll rename this sixth working note as carrying cost of investment. Like I told you, this is the change on the asset side of the consolidated balance sheet. Keep it relaxed, guys. What we'll do is, we'll see it in combination with reserves for CBS. I'm saying we'll see it in combination because the change here and the change here both should be same. Otherwise, your balance sheet will not tally. A holding company balance sheet which is already tallying, which is already given to you, if I am changing a figure on the asset side, one figure on the liability side, then definitely the change in the asset and the change in the liability should be exactly the same points of change. So let's see. First, when I am talking about cost of investment, leave carrying cost of investment, cost of investment. If you remember, in your cost of control, how do we calculate goodwill or capital reserve? Cost of investment will be compared with share in net assets. Share in net assets is divided between share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. When we compare these two, this gave us a goodwill or capital reserve. If I give you these three figures, can you calculate cost of investment? I can. Correct. Let's say my cost of investment was 120, my net assets was 100, goodwill was 20. If I don't give you 120, can you calculate cost of investment? Yeah. How do you calculate? Share in net assets plus goodwill, or share in net assets minus capital reserve. Correct? Let's try to do the same thing. I won't start with cost of investment. What I'm start doing is the same cost of control working note, I'll put it in a reverse manner. I'll start with share in net assets of associate on the date of acquisition. The share in net assets as given by share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. To these two, if I add goodwill or if I deduct capital reserve, whatever is the case that you already got in your step 5, we have already got that value in the step 5, either goodwill or capital reserve. If I place the figure here, then what I get is cost of investment . This is already there in the balance sheet. This is already there in the balance sheet. We are just deriving it in a reverse manner. But what is the difference between a cost of investment and carrying cost of investment? We have to add something here. Then we find out what is the carrying cost of investment. The difference between the cost of investment and carrying cost of investment should be the same difference that you get in reserves for CBS. How do you do reserves for CBS? H Limited balance, holding company balance of reserves. And come on, what do we add? Share in post-acquisition reserves of associate. You added this on the liability side. Don't you think you need to add it even on the asset side? Add it on the asset side. Add post-acquisition reserves. Share in post-acquisition reserves of associate. This is a share, guys, not the entire one. Only your share. That is what we calculated as per as your distribution of reserve is concerned. So we add this in the even on the asset side as well. What else? Plus post acquisition dividend from associate. Correct? This is also to be added to your post acquisition reserves. That post acquisition dividend can either be received or can be receivable. Correct? It is already received or it is yet to be received. That means they are proposing today. Obviously, it is receivable. What is already received? Liability side is increasing. At the same time, here cash also increases. Correct? So, obviously, it will tally. So, I don't have to give an impact to the carrying cost at all. But what about receivable? Receivable, cash is not increasing there. So what do I have to do? I have to add it to your carrying cost of investment to make it tally. Plus post acquisition dividend receivable from associate. Add these two, you get carrying cost of investment. Observe one thing, the change in the asset side and the change in the liability side are absolutely the same. We have this share in post acquisition reserve here. We have this share in post acquisition reserve here. You can say that these two are related. My post acquisition dividend receivable from associate here and a post-acquisition dividend receivable here. Yes, I did not add what is received because I already got cash. So already cash is increasing on the asset side, I don't have to add that. So these two are your working notes which are necessary for you to prepare consolidated balance sheet with an associate. Only these two changes will appear. Rest everything is of no use. So whenever you are talking about pre-acquisition, this pre-acquisition I have used in cost of control, step 5. But post-acquisition reserves, I used at both the places. I used it at the carrying cost of investment. And also your reserves for CBS. Because my change on the asset side and the liability side should absolutely be the same. This is probably the easiest consolidation possible. Because there is no actual consolidation which is happening. Net assets of the associate are not getting added to the holding company at all. Yes, guys, read the question number 31. Consolidated data of X Limited and 100% subsidiary Y Limited and also the information of Z Limited will relate into the year 31st March 2012 are given. He already consolidated with the subsidiary X and Y. He has given that. Z Limited is also given to you. And he is saying that the P&L is given to you and X Limited acquired 50% of the ordinary shares of Z on 1st April 2011 for 2000 thousands when its reserve was 1900 and sold this holding on 3rd April. That means on 31st March he is still having the controlling interest over it for 2005-2050. You are required to prepare a group P&L and the group balance sheet Z Limited when it is treated as subsidiary, associate, investment, joint venture, everything possible. So you need to treat Z Limited as subsidiary and follow full consolidation. You need to treat it as an associate and follow AS 23 equity method. You need to treat it as a joint venture and follow proportionate consolidation method. You need to treat it as an investment and then solve the answer. So basically there are four balance sheets, four consolidated balance sheets which we have to prepare in total. So what we'll try to do is, at least for the learning perspective, let's try to divide our page into four sheets and let's try to compare how we solve in a different way for each different way. Okay, so let's make it into four parts. The first one we'll keep it for the subsidiary, second one we'll keep it for the joint venture, third one for the associate and last one for the investment. Leave one column space, guys, at least a small space so that we can write the index part of it and then start. I need broader columns, guys, so use at least two sheets. When you're treating it as a subsidiary, when you treat it as a joint venture, when you're treating it as an associate, I'm going to have broader lines. When you treat it as an associate and then finally when you're treating it as investment. First, write with standard applicable. Subsidiary 21. Joint venture 27, associate 23, investment 13. Method of consolidation. Subsidiary. Full consolidation method. Joint venture. Proportionate consolidation method. Associate. Equity. Investment, there is no consolidation that we do. Let's try to frame it accordingly. Now let's start with the steps of consolidation. The first step that I need is date of acquisition. Continue. What is the date of acquisition? 1st April That's the date of acquisition. Try to understand the shareholding pattern. There's no number of shares given if you read. It directly gave only the percentage. That's it. They hold 50%. So no number of shares, only give it in the form of percentages. Percentage holding. Holding company H Limited holds. Sorry, holding company is X Limited. X Limited holds 50%. Minority hold 50%. I know there is no controlling interest, but still he is asking you to treat it as subsidiary. Let's treat it. But when we write it for the joint venture, we don't write it this way because there is no minority. We just write it as venturer's interest. In the joint venture, 50%. Associate, we call it as investing party interest. You don't need to do it as investment at all. Then come to the next one. Do I need analysis, guys? There is no change, right? There is only distribution that is required. So we can combine both analysis as well as distribution. What is the reserve of Z Limited? Check the balance sheet. The reserve of Z Limited is 2000. Now, what is the reserve given down below on the date of acquisition? 1900. So, analysis and distribution of reserves. Start with balance as on balance sheet date. Balance sheet date is 31st March 2012. Balance is 2000. Balance as on 1st April 2011 on the date of acquisition 1900. Balance is current year profit of 2011-12, 100, 1900 is pre-acquisition, 100 is post-acquisition. Split it, distribute off directly. X and minority, again X and minority. X 950, 50, 50. What about here? Balance as on 31st March 2012, 2000, split. Balance as on 1st April 2011, 1900, this is pre-acquisition, and my current year profit of 100 is post acquisition. I don't have to split it into two parts, guys, not at all required, because I'm only calculating for venturer's interest. Venturer's interest of 50% is 950, and here the venturer's interest is 50. Similarly for this, balance as on 31st March 2012 is 2000. Split it into two parts. Balance as on 1st April 2011 is 1900 with current year profit of 100. 100 considered as post-acquisition reserve and 1900 considered as pre-acquisition reserve. Calculate investing party interest. Only investing party, no minority, 950 and 50. Nothing in the investment column, guys. Next one, cost of control. Cost of investment. What is the cost of investment? Check the investment column, asset side. Investment in Z acquired at a cost of 2000. Compare with share in net assets. Split between share capital and pre-acquisition reserves. Share capital, 50% of the share capital in Z. Z's total share capital is 1000, 50%, 500. Pre-acquisition reserve, 950. Total, 1450. That means I get a goodwill of 550. Guys, if you observe, the calculation in every case will be the same. So, I can say that the goodwill of joint venture in the same way should also be 550. And even here, my amount of goodwill will be 550. But the only difference is, in the case of AS 21 subsidiary and 27 joint venture, these goodwills will appear in the consolidated balance sheet. But this 550 rupees, we will use it in carrying cost of investment. We do not consider it for the purpose of consolidated balance sheet at all. We do not consider it for the consolidated balance sheet. We only consider it in carrying cost of investment. Let's try to push it forward. After your cost of investment, what else do you need? Cost of control, next. I need minority interest. Minority interest, when we are calculating, guys, we are only calculating for subsidiary. So nothing in the joint venture, associate and investment columns. Only fill up your subsidiary column with that. Their share in share capital. Total share capital in Z is 1000. 50% the whole, 500. Their share in the reserves. We have already analyzed and distributed. Pre-acquisition and post-acquisition reserves. Pre-acquisition reserve 950. Post-acquisition reserve 50. Total minority interest is 1500. Before we go for results for CBS, I need one more working known for associate only. That is carrying cost of investment. There is no carrying cost of investment for subsidiary and joint venture. Only in the case of associate we need to calculate. Where do we start with? We start with share in net assets. Then we add goodwill or deduct capital reserve so that we get cost of investment. To get carrying cost of investment, again we have to add one more item. We'll see that. Share in net assets. Share capital. Check your cost of control working note. Exact reverse calculation I have to do. Share capital of 500. Pre-acquisition reserve is 950. My share in net asset is 1450. To this add goodwill 550. I will get cost of investment 2000. Then next, what is that we have to add? Share in post acquisition reserves. Post acquisition reserves of Z is 50. And then post acquisition dividend receivable from Z. There's no dividend receivable, I'm just writing the item, that's it. There's no value actually receivable. Just to remind you people, there's one more addition. So this 2050 is called as carrying cost of investment. Reserves for CBS is same for all the columns. We need to start with the holding company reserve and we will add share in subsidiaries reserve. Check holding company's reserve. X Limited reserve is 3450 already given. X Limited balance of reserve 3450 plus share in post acquisition reserves of Z 50. Item is amount is the same in all cases except for investment because there's no CBS in investments. Sufficient information. Let's try to compare the balance sheets now. Guys, when you're preparing balance sheet, try to, if you have completed, no problem. If you have this some space, you can continue. Otherwise, maintain four amount columns, that is sufficient. Because the items are anyways the same. We have anyways the similar items. only the amounts will change. Subsidiary, when it is a joint venture, when it is an associate, and when it is only an investment. Consolidated balance sheet of X as on 31st March 2012. Regular framework of balance sheet. Start with equity and liabilities. Under equity and liabilities, shareholder funds. Under shareholder funds, share capital will not change, guys. So always the ordinary shares are 2000. Investment, associate, joint venture or subsidiary, always it is the same figure. Reserves and surplus. There is only one reserve. Which we just calculated. We already had 3450. We added post acquisition reserve. My reserves for CBS became 3500 throughout. Except for investment, where I did not consolidate, I'll have the same figure, 3450. Minority interest, we calculated only for subsidiary. Value of minority interest was 1500. It will not appear in any other form of joint venture or associate or investment. There is a non-current liability, that is a debenture. Check the value of debentures. In full consolidation under subsidiary, I will write debentures 2000 plus 1500 in subsidiary 3500. Joint venture. Proportionate consolidation. Debenture is a part of net assets. Check now. 2000 plus, not 1500. My share in the joint venture is 50%. 50% of 1500 is only 750, so the answer should be only 2750. Proportionate. Associate, no consolidation, no change in net assets. Net asset will be 2000, be it associate or investment. Associate, one change we have already done in reserves for CBS. The next change should only be in your cost, carrying cost of investment. Until then, you don't get any change. Current liabilities. Current liabilities, full consolidation. First, 4550 plus 2500 is total 7050. Proportionate. 4550 plus 50% of 2500. 2500, 50% is 1250. So this should be 5,800. 4550 plus 50% of 2,500, that is 1250, is 5,800. No consolidation for associate 4550 and 4550. Now I'll give you the total for the liabilities sign, then go for the assets. Non-current assets, tangible fixed assets, full consolidation 6500 plus 4000 and a subsidiary full consolidation will give you 10,500. But proportionate consolidation for joint venture 6500 plus 50% of 4000, 2000, 8500. Associate, no consolidation, only the holding company share 6500. Investment also only holding company 6500. Intangible asset, goodwill. Goodwill will appear. What is the amount of goodwill that we got? We got a goodwill of 550 rupees. That 550 rupees will appear only for subsidiary and joint venture. Though I calculated goodwill for associate, it will not be presented in the balance sheet at all. Carrying cost of investment in associate. This item will appear only for the associate. Carrying cost of investment. Carrying cost of investment, we already calculated the amount as 2050. And what about investment? Investments column, it will be 2000 only. That 50 won't be added. Current assets, go for full consolidation, 3500 plus 3000 is 6500. Next one, proportionate, 3500 plus 50% of 3000, 1500, 5000. Associate and investment, no consolidation, straightforward figures, 3500 and 3500. Balance sheet should tally here. First one is 14,500. How much? 12050. Is 12,000. There we can comparatively understand how to solve a problem under 20, 21, 27, 23 and 13. Yes guys, to have a better understanding, intercompany owings, what did we do when I had intercompany owings and subsidiary? We used to cancel. So cancel in full. But for a joint venture, first of all, why did we cancel? Because the net assets were taken over completely, so I'm cancelling in full. Joint venture, am I taking over the net assets completely? Proportionately. So, cancel proportionately. Associate, no cancellation at all. Investment, same, no cancellation. Why no cancellation? Because the net assets are not taken over. Because I never took over the net assets, why will I cancel? Same logic applies even for unrealized profit. Unrealized profit on intercompany transactions also, you will have same logic. So this is a basic framework of the entire consolidation chapter, which can be summarized with this one problem. Well, I know 50% cannot be controlling interest, 50% cannot be a joint venture, whatever it is, we are just trying to put across how is it different when we are treating it as a subsidiary, when you treat it as a joint venture, when treat it as an associate or an investment. So this will give you our basic framework or the entire outlook. So whenever we get some comparison or whenever we get a doubt between each of the consolidation methods, one problem will solve all the issues. So once you check this problem, you will completely understand where each amount was actually taken. Got it?